Step 3 of the 5-step model requires us to determine the transaction price. The general principle is that the transaction price is the amount of consideration to which an entity expects to be entitled in exchange for transferring promised goods and services to a customer, excluding amounts collected on behalf of third parties, for example GST. There are a number of requirements that need to be considered here, depending on the complexity of the contract with the customer. For example, you need to consider what the customary business practices are and whether there are variable considerations. If the payment of a transaction price is payable after more than 12 months, you need to consider if there's a financing component. More complex arrangements could involve non-cash consideration or consideration payable to the customer. Here we will focus on variable consideration and how to apply IFRS 15 requirements in the determination of the transaction price. IFRS 15, paragraph 53, allows two methods for calculating variable consideration. The first is the expected value method, which is the sum of all probability-weighted amounts in a range of possible consideration amounts. The second is the most likely method, which is the single most likely amount in a range of possible consideration amounts. For example, Fashion Limited sells 100 jackets to a retailer with a selling price of $50 each, excluding GST. The contract allows the retailer to return jackets that it does not sell for a full refund if returned within 30 days. Based on past experience, Fashion Limited believes that there is a 30% chance that no jackets would be returned, while there is a 45% chance that 10 jackets would be returned. There is only a 25% chance that 20 jackets would be returned. What would be the transaction price if Fashion Limited applied the expected value method and the most likely method? Using the expected value method, we would apply the following steps. 1. Calculate the revenue associated with each scenario. 2. Multiply the revenue outcome for each scenario by the probability related to its occurrence. And 3. Add the probability-weighted amounts together. So applying step 1, the revenue associated with 0 jackets returned is $5,000, which is $50 times 100 jackets. The revenue associated with 10 jackets returned is $4,500, which is 90 jackets times $50. Similarly, the revenue associated with 20 jackets returned is $4,000, which is 80 jackets times $50. Applying step 2, the amount of $5,000 of revenue occurring is multiplied by the probability of 30%. This gives us a weighted probability amount of $1,500, that is 5,000 times 30%. The same calculation is applied to the scenarios where 10 jackets and 20 jackets are returned. Applying step 3, we would simply add the weighted probabilities together and get an expected value transaction price of $4,525, that is 1,500 plus 2,025. Plus 1,000. If Fashion Limited uses the most likely method, then the transaction price would be $4,500. This is because of all the scenarios, the one where the customer would return 10 jackets has the highest probability, which is 45%. So the most likely transaction price would be $4,500. IFRS 15, paragraph 56, contains an important requirement relating to variable considerations that can be included in the transaction price. The amount is restricted to only that which is highly probable that a significant reversal in amount would not occur. To recap, where a contract includes a variable consideration, the transaction price can be determined using either the expected value method or the most likely method.